You write about the famous hug when Comey was asked to come with a bunch of other law enforcement agents to the White House soon after the inauguration.
Comey really did not want to go to that meeting. There were a lot of Democrats who kind of blame him for Trump. So he was particularly sensitive to the idea of a sort of show of intimacy or closeness with Trump. That said, he didn't feel that he could say no to an invitation from the president. So he went, and it's actually a funny story. He really wanted to kind of blend in and not be singled out. And he's 6'8". So it's when
it's
you're
kind of tough to do
when
that.
You're 6'8", it's really hard to blend in. He's wearing, if you watch the video of it, he's wearing a blue blazer, and he stands in the part of the room that is as far from Trump as it is physically possible to be, and also against blue drapes that are the same color as his.
He chose that spot?
He chose that spot because it was, you know, like almost like a chameleon, you know, camouflaged
blend
against
in.
The wall. And then at the end, right at the end, Trump singles him out in a fashion that he regarded as sort of, you know, calculated to maximally drive home this sensitivity among Democratic voters, which is to say, I forget the exact quote, hey, look, he's even more famous than I am.
He's become more famous than me.
And he extends his hand kind of preemptively, and Trump grabs the hand and kind of pulls him into a hug. But the hug is entirely one-sided. And Comey was just completely disgusted. Disgusted by the episode. He thought it was an intentional attempt to compromise him in public in a way that would sow and emphasize concerns that half of the electorate had about him and the Bureau.